Hey, it is your buddy, Peace and Harmony, with you here today. And we are zooming in and focusing in on a very important topic with a covert narcissist, and that is the core issue of you don't get what you see. You don't see what you get. When you are dealing with a covert narcissist, you are dealing with a personality disorder, a cluster B, for one who is highly secretive in nature. In other words, they don't wear their emotions on the surface. They don't communicate what they are truly thinking. They don't share with you the common give and take, the law of reciprocity with others. They tend to be very quiet, very much in a withdrawn or retreative sort of state. They might go and kind of hang out in the corner. They might be kind of very unsocial, yet they're very charming. They're very intelligent. They're very capable of having intellectual discussions, soulful discussions, nurturing discussions, but they choose not to. They choose to just keep and kind of hoard all of their thoughts to themselves. And the issue with this is not so much the fact that they are hoarding this within themselves, but it's more the fact you don't see what you get. With most people or most trustworthy people, what you see is what you get. There is nothing there to hide. There is nothing there in the corner, swept underneath the couch, the rug, the lamp. It is all out in the open. They are living their life freely. To keep everything secretive is part of the issue with a covert narcissist, in that they tend to have really sort of an apathetic or irresponsible accountability to others. In other words, they have a pathological sense of self-importance, and they will defend this tenet within their personality at all costs. In other words, they will attract to them what they need to maintain their happy space or their pathological sense of self-importance. So whether it's a male or female, it doesn't make any difference, but they tend to be very autonomous, independent, and retreating. And it's not so much what they give, it's what they don't give. It's not so much what they communicate, it's so much what they don't communicate. And it's the fact that they will be very sort of to themselves, not like the quiet loner who is just, doing their own little thing and, not harming a fly. And just kind of, bopping along. It's more the fact that they tend to then set up situations where they can then exploit others or take advantage of them or not give them what they need so that they won't rise up or become, full blossomed individuals, because that is an inherent threat to them and a threat to their feeling of being internally impoverished. So if these individuals, as a covert narcissist, are escaping to the basement, doing God knows what, drinking whiskey, just re retreating into an absent state. This behavior then signals to most people on an unconscious level that they are not desirable to be with. In other words, they cannot attend to them. They are not worth the time of day, and so they must escape. They cannot deal with other people. They have this chronic impoverished state, which causes them to withdraw. Whether they withdraw to the basement, whether they withdraw to the garage, the attic, their study, their office, they might be piddling around, but they, have a sense that you don't really get, you don't see what you get, you don't get what you see. What you get is sort of the projection or the feeling that this person is needy, but you quite don't know what it is because they cannot communicate it. And it is this lack of communication that becomes so stifling when you're with them, and it creates an analysis, a need for person to believe the relationship is more in the head than in the heart. And this withdrawal is really because there's this withholding. The body then also receives this as an attack. When you are not acknowledged or validated, the body tends to enter into a state of fear, the fight or flight. the feeling where the brainstem is just living in that primordial lower state of survival. In other words, you know, you're stuck on that analytic, what can I do to please this person? And then that's how the covert narcissist gets these people working and running and doing things for them, or living life close at hand to be there through these invisible cords that keep people psychically stuck, psychically connected. And so really then it's to understand that if you're in this always hyper and, you know, analytic state, overthinking things, feeling like you can't really move a state away, you know, move a country away, pursue a certain career because you're psychically, you know, there's a psychic cord that's connecting you. It is because the covert narcissist has you there for a reason: to take care of them, to wash their clothes, cook their dinner, clean their house, buy their house, choose their religion. Whatever it is, you'll find that those people around them have to do the monkey dance in order to keep everything assembled in line and functioning. So there's this feeling that you have this charming, wonderful, intelligent person who is radiating or resonating energetically that they are important. And oftentimes they are important because everyone is important. But then they have to see this air of superiority, which oftentimes gets them jobs, positions, lovers, etc. But yet what they truly give and who they project themselves out is not the same. And so this is part of the issue, part of the problem. You don't get what you see, you don't see what you get. It's kind of like a tiger. You know, you see the stripes, but their skin is also. So a tiger is a tiger. They won't change their stripes. You know, they won't change their polka dots. What have you as a jaguar. You know, what you see is what you get with the tiger and the jaguar and the leopard. You know, those animal prints, they are who they say they are. There's not this turtle-like personality where, you know, there's a shell and then an inside, or an inner self and an outer self. You know, it's all the way through. They are transparent. And oftentimes you feel a sense of ease or peace around these people because they are transparent. What you see is what you get. And there's a state of clarity or energetic enthusiasm or passion around these people because they're like the element of air. They are, you know, they are transparent. What you see is what you get. There's not a lot hiding. And so the issue then, if you have been with a relationship with a covert narcissist where you have found that you have then had to live your life in your head, always trying to analyze things. This is a message to you then, to then come into your heart, live from your heart, do what your heart tells you to, and do not doubt yourself. This is your buddy, Peace and Harmony, with you here today. I hope these videos do help. Please share, please subscribe for more great tools, videos, discussion, and support.